We all have our favorite game engines. The one that makes your eyes light up. The one you see yourself growing old with. But, like any marriage, you eventually start to notice flaws. As for me, I mainly used Unity and a little bit of Godot after a recent divorce, so I have some experience with the good and the bad of both. And lately I've been thinking, what would a game engine look like that had all the upsides with none of the flaws? And before we start, keep in mind that I'm talking about my ideal game engine here. I'm sure you've got opinions of your own, so share them in the comments or on my Discord. This aspect in particular is definitely drawn from my experience with Godot, especially in comparison with Unity. On the surface, both engines seem pretty similar. You've got the scene tree, the inspector, the asset viewer, etc. But where Godot largely stops at nodes and resources, with scenes to connect the two, Unity has game objects, components, mono behavior scripts, resources, prefabs, scenes. I could go on. Don't get me wrong, all these ideas serve distinct, useful purposes, but Godot has the hindsight to generalize them into a few key concepts. And this applies to more than the fundamental building blocks of projects. Let's say you wanted to make some 3D fish in Unity for a little visual flair. Do you manually clone game objects, use an object pooler, or use a particle system? If you want to animate them, should you use a vertex shader or a regular animation? If you want a sleek sheen on the fish's body, should you use a custom shader or a built-in material? If you do want a custom shader, should that be a shader graph or a GLSL script? These questions are easy for experienced game devs, but they can get overwhelming quickly for a newer user. You might experience decision paralysis or end up choosing a suboptimal solution. Of course, Godot isn't perfect about this either, but you normally don't have to ask these questions until you get into more advanced features. Auto load or a custom scene loader? Object or ref counted? I've been talking about situations where there's more than one obvious way to do something, but what about when there's no obvious way to do something? For example, neither Godot nor Unity comes with a one-size-fits-all save system. Both engines require you to roll your own. With Unity, that usually involves serializing a bunch of variables and writing them to a binary file. The Godot documentation describes a simpler system where you save certain nodes as JSON data. It makes you wonder why the Unity team spent so much time and money on the particle system while neglecting a feature as important as saving your game. If you're going to ignore such important features, why not just stick to developing the core engine and leave the extra features to the community? I'm talking about... My ideal engine would pare back the bells and whistles. Instead of adding fancy features, focus on making the core of the engine performant, cross-platform, and flexible. There's plenty of work for engine developers right there. This approach wouldn't just make it easier for engine developers, it would also bolster the community. Pretty much all the packages I added to my last game, Breezy, were open source, which is a great trend. It lets the community fix bugs and contribute features, and it fosters a culture of learning and improvement. There are also plenty of closed-source packages and assets that cost money, which is fine too. The point is that you get to weigh the benefits or drawbacks of each option. Now imagine that you've opened up a new Unity project, and instead of adding a terrain object, generating a procedural skybox, and configuring a character controller, all things that are included in the Unity engine by default, you downloaded open source plugins for all these things. You can mix and match plugins for the best features, and the engine makes it easy to create your own if you're not satisfied. Unity has been trending in this direction for the past few years, with things like the new input system being external packages, but there's still plenty of ground to cover. Compared to Unity, Godot is a lot leaner, but even it has unnecessary features. The animated sprite 2D is neat, but couldn't it be done by the community? Same goes for the tile map feature. To be fair, Godot is open source, that is, developed by the community, so the same people making external plugins could also be the ones developing the engine. Maybe the tile map feature started out as an external plugin idea, but one of the engine developers got wind of it and said, oh, send me a PR and I'll add it to the engine. Also, I keep talking about refining the core engine, but that's a pretty subjective term in itself. Would Unity's animation system be considered a core part of the engine? What about the UI system? My ideal engine would be as lean as possible, following the axiom do one thing well, with that thing being exporting complex games to multiple platforms. In that last section, I was talking about engine features. Now, though, I'm talking about the editor itself. I want game engines to follow in the footsteps of IDEs like VS Code and Emacs, with more custom themes, plugins, and UIs for the editor itself. To be fair, we're in a better place here than we were a few years ago when Unity's dark theme was restricted to premium users. This is one area where Godot needs work, in my opinion. I just don't like the built-in script editor, since it's missing some pretty essential features like symbol renaming. But it doesn't seem like external editors are supported as much as Godot's built-in editor. My ideal Unreal Engine would focus on external editors from day one. I've already touched on open source, and it should go without saying that my ideal editor is fully free, open source, and permissively licensed. Godot is the gold standard here, and as I mentioned in a video about a year ago, I think the industry is only going to trend further towards open source software. Why is this important to customizability? Well, open source software is naturally more customizable. Not only can you add a new setting or theme, but you can also fork the whole project if need be, and make whatever changes you want. When I talk about customizability, an important part is in-editor tooling and scripts. It should be easy to quickly automate something, like renaming a bunch of files, but there should also be a clear pathway towards more complex scripts and build systems. It's important to note that, although customizability is great, it can also sometimes be at odds with modularity. If we're doing everything through external plugins, those now have to conform to crazy custom themes and interfaces too. Well, engine developers can help here as well, since they're the ones that provide the building blocks for plugin developers. My ideal engine is built from the ground up around both customizability and modularity. It's more effort for the engine developers, but it makes the lives of plugin developers a lot easier. This last point is something I've been thinking about more often since I've been doing more collaborative games. While working together with other game devs, it's essential to use a version control system like Git, paired with a hosting platform like GitHub to synchronize your work. But Git and GitHub aren't 100% suited for game development. Game projects tend to include a lot of binary files and resources that are edited with the game engine, not a text editor. Git is built around merging files by comparing them line by line in a text editor, which you just can't do with, for example, a sprite stored in a PNG file. Git and GitHub are better suited for text-based projects with constant slow iteration and large development teams. Something like the Linux kernel, which Git was invented to help with. My ideal editor would include, whether as a plugin or an integrated feature, a new version control system for game development. Unity has something very close to what I'm describing, a custom version control system that tracks moved assets and empty folders, but it seems to be geared towards paid, enterprise use. I'd also want a hosting platform similar to GitHub, only designed around this custom system instead of Git. Beyond that, I'd like to see an integrated knowledge base, again as a plugin or a core feature. Maybe you could place notes on assets similar to documentation for scripts. Each project could come with a notebook similar to a vault in Obsidian where you could record knowledge in Markdown and add links to assets or scripts in your project. And now that Trello's free plan is becoming more restrictive, why not include a task tracking system as well? That way the editor could basically become your whole workflow. Or, remember modularity, you could ignore all this stuff and just make games. Of course, when it comes to collaborative features, I'm aware that you can't host all this for free. Instead of being owned by a mega corporation, my ideal engine would sustain itself by charging a low, flat rate per organization. Just like Obsidian lets me pay about $2 per month to sync my notes between my phone and laptop, this engine would let me pay, let's say, $5 a month to sync the version control system, the knowledge base, the task tracking, and more. Or if you wanted to self-host everything on your own servers, you could do it for free with open source server software. So I realize I just spent an entire video whining about two existing game engines, but I love those too. Even if they're not ideal, they're still extremely impressive pieces of software. Taking a big picture look at my ideal game engine, it's still maybe 90% a mix of Unity and Godot. But even with this engine being so similar to existing ones, we could still ask, is it likely that a game engine like this will ever appear? I think so. A few years ago, users of Unity and other game engines stepped back, took a critical look at the flaws of their engines, and helped create Godot. And just like that engine addresses a lot of Unity's problems, I'm confident that we'll see an engine one day that addresses the problems with Godot and other hip engines. So, that's my radical vision for the future. Sorry this video came out so late, I've been pretty busy with school. On the bright side, my next video might be very interesting. We'll just have to see, I guess. Or, for the impatient, you can always join my Discord server for early updates. Have a good day.